Right, this is a react. Bit of a throwback for me. I was going through some of the old Asking Alexandria, and when this one came on, I thought, you know what? Out of all the stuff to go back to, this is a classic for me, even though it's off the third album. There's a lot on Stand Up and Scream and Reckless and Relentless that are good tracks, but I'm going to go with this one. This is also first video I've uploaded since some information I've got that one of my videos got taken down. Initially, I thought it was a copyright thing, but it was actually due to the content in the video. It was the skin school shooting Columbine one, which I guess it makes sense, but I was also like, I don't know how, like, obviously Skinned made a video about it, and I don't know how, like, they get past the YouTube sort of guidelines with that, but yeah, I'll quickly get on with this. But there's new information for me. But yeah, from Death to Destiny's album, there's a lot of good tracks on this one. I definitely cover a lot more, as I'm a big fan of Asking. I've seen him live last year. Again, with that comment I just made about the inappropriate content, which it did specify, I assume it's just because of the nature of the video. Yeah, it was very vague. I guess not really into the video with some just a shot in it. Nice slow intro, but it'll soon kick into it. And also recently, I went back and listened to some of the less popular tracks on, well, I don't know exactly, just the ones they didn't do videos on from The Black, the one which didn't have Danny in. I will replay this just while I'm talking, and there's some good tracks that obviously it'd be, you know, there's a legit reason they can just use, which is, you know, it didn't have Danny in, so that I can see why they don't do it live. But there's some tracks that I think if they had Ben Bruce, because he obviously covers some lyrics in a lot of the songs, but if he sang the lyrics in songs like Gone, which I think is really good, and is it something it ends, I can't remember what it's called now. I'll possibly look at that after. I'll just pull this back. But yeah, there's some good songs that I could see him actually playing live, but I'd obviously have to switch it around. Also, because this is the third album, a lot of the comments that Ben Bruce makes, and this is obviously to do with a lot of the albums on how getting famous and whatever for Danny had a lot of negative effects. Shown very well in Death of Me, which I guess it's got a music video, so I forgot to look at that one. Goes to a softer bit, but yeah, it's got that classic sort of, I was gonna say grunge, but I don't think that's really a grunge vocals, but because obviously earlier albums than this one were very what people think of when they think of metal slash heavy metal, very shouty, screamy vocals. But Danny, around this stage, was wrecking his voice, so I don't think he could keep that up, and he had to sort of can it. That's obviously Ben Bruce talking about, is having to go into rehab for, I don't know if it's because obviously I guess I may as well cover it if I do. Death of Me, it's shown really well through the video and the lyrics of Death of Me that I think he chose, was it drugs, but when he got money he got all like heroin, alcohol, and obviously that's not going to do too good. I've been so fucked up for so long, and I can't keep my head up out the bottom. Holy fuck, my time on it, I'm never gonna get any fat. I'm waiting so long to the club, I don't give a fuck if I'm tired. Holy shit, lost my mind, reality is starting to unwind. But yeah, that's the, that timing was actually quite good. I didn't really plan that, but that whole verse or whatever was pretty much covering it, that he's singing it. Not specifically in this one. This is one that kind of showed how they did Run Free and Final Episode. Final Episode a bit heavier, and Someone Somewhere, Moving On. They're songs that they've got heavy parts to them, but they've got a lot of softer vocals, which this is showing. So I could see them actually playing this one live. But yeah, that was Don't Pray For Me off of, from Death Till Destiny, the third album they did before then. He would have his issues with his voice being broken. He went and did songs with We Are Harlot. He did a self-titled album, his country stuff. We Are Harlot were kind of rocky more than anything heavy, but I think he just wanted to do something else while taking a step away from Asking Alexandria. But it's good that he's back, done some good albums since, and I definitely keep covering Asking Alexandria. There's honestly, in my opinion, there's so almost every album's got about more than half of it of bangers, even nowadays with the newer stuff, which has got taken a bit of a different direction. But yeah, I'll leave that till next time. I definitely might, well, definitely might cover Death of Me off of the same album, because the music video is very important for how Danny was at the time. But yeah, that's it for now.